When Lady Freesia Forestwish left the palace of the Asterlance after visiting Princess Amelia for the first time, she knew that the illness that tormented the heir to the throne of Norloch was something the Animarchs called Bristenem. For that, herbs alone were not enough. But Lady Freesia was a herbalist, and she was expected to find a cure for the princess through her vast knowledge of herbs. On the first day of her visit, she made a cup of silver star flower tea and shared stories of herbs, willow wisps, and the animarchs with the princess. The princess was touched by the stories and interested in learning more, but Lady Freesia realized that none of that was new to her. She came back to share more stories and teach the princess more. The stories about the wild meadows and mountains of Meadowgrass were like medicine to her heart, and her cheeks began to recover their delicate pink hue. However, whenever Lady Freesia suggested a short visit to the village, the princess seemed to ignore her and suggested a visit to the royal gardens instead. Lady Freesia, however, knew that despite her fears, visiting Meadowgrass was something that Princess Amelia wished for. Meeting after meeting, the princess recovered some of her strength and appetite. Lady Freesia had the impression that the princess had been reflecting, considering something that has given her strength. But sadly, her body was still weak and her eyes full of sorrow. Lady Freesia was confident that she could help the princess if she could gain the trust of her and her parents, but her thoughts troubled her. This was not the first case of Bristenem that Lady Freesia had seen, but it was certainly the most difficult. Not because of the symptoms, but because she was a princess. According to the Animarchs, Bristenem occurs when our souls lose connection with ourselves. When we leave our lives of someone else and we give up on our dreams. The items found in Princess Amelia's room hid hints of her true nature, but it was her diary that revealed her deepest desires. The afternoon the princess showed her poems and drawings to Lady Freesia was the moment the latter made up her mind about the future steps of the treatment. She asked the princess if she felt strong enough to ride a horse. The princess nodded. That same evening, she informed Princess Amelia that they would need to visit Meadowgrass Village to get a herb that could only be found and consumed there. This time, the princess didn't ignore her, and with teary eyes, asked her maids to summon her parents. Lady Freesia nervously requested their permission, which was immediately granted. Two horses were also made available for the journey, as requested by Lady Freesia. The two ladies departed early in the morning, wearing plain linen garments and kerchiefs. When they were crossing the pastures of Quiet Pond, Lady Freesia watched in awe as Princess Amelia clutched the horse's reins and broke into a gallop. She certainly didn't look like the weak maiden she had met days before. The Hours went by, and Lady Freesia wasn't sure which was the moment she saw Princess Amelia at her best. Perhaps it was when she let her hair dance in the wind as she galloped her horse. Or maybe it was when she walked barefoot, picking flowers and berries from the field. But most probably, it was when she convinced her new friend to swim in the river. Before returning to the palace, the herbalist granted the princess a last wish, and they rode their horses to the Forest of Tales, which marks the beginning of the road to the Animas. Princess Amelia seemed to know the forest by heart. Lady Freesia followed her. In front of an ancient oak, they got down from their horses. The princess observed the tree and climbed it. She put her hand in a hollow that seemed to be full of dead leaves. She took out a little box and jumped down to show Lady Freesia her hidden treasure. Inside the box were many kinds of amulets and little trinkets. The princess observed them carefully. She took one of the items and replaced it with her bracelet. She hurried up to put the box back in the tree and jumping to the highest branch she could reach, she stretched her body and let her soul howl. The majestic oak tree, standing tall and wise, witnessed the princess' transformation. Lady Freesia could see hope and determination sprouting from her sad eyes, and at that moment she realized that the princess had a plan and was ready to reclaim her destiny. When Lady Freesia and Princess Amelia set out on their journey back from the Forest of Tales in Meadowgrass Village to the Palace of Asterlance in Mortloch, they let the horses walk unhurriedly, as if that could slow down time. As they marched, they ate the berries and fruit pies they had picked in the village from their wicker baskets. Lady Freesia wouldn't have dared disturb the silence, only interrupted by the singing birds and the sudden rushes of wind that filled the air with the sweet scent of wild flowers and berries. The Princess Amelia started to speak. When I was a child, my grandfather used to bring me to these lands and beyond. He touched people with his infectious love and care for the animals. It was him who officially recognized the lands. He always fought for their rights. But after he fell ill on the other side of the mountains, his love grew stronger for one of them, Miran, a healer of the river Onam. My grandfather decided to stay with them, so we would visit him regularly. I would spend months with them. I loved the freedom and sense of community, their connection to nature, the spirituality, and their abilities. There was no other place in the world where I felt happier. The princess made a pause, and Lady Freesia could feel her nostalgia as she looked into the distance. There I met Anna and Nobel, my best friends, with whom I hid the little trinkets in the ancient oak. Everything was perfect. My parents treated them as children of their own. Until some summers ago, the three of us performed with the Animax band in Meadowgrass Village at the Festival of Summer Wonders. I wasn't a child anymore and people started to recognize me. Apparently I wasn't what they expected from their princess. So my parents, trying to do the best for me, sent me to a royal academy. But they rejected me because of my wilderness. Later they assigned me a governess. She showed me what is expected of me and taught me to be the person I should be. The confessions of the princess were utterly heartbreaking. However, her voice sounded determined, as if she confidently knew that something was about to change. I should thank you, Mrs. Forestwish, for you were the one who understood that it was my soul, not my body, that was truly aching. When you told me about all the things you learned from the Animax, you reminded me of one of their sayings that goes, "Never bear in your heart the things that are meant for your hands." My grandfather was a man of action. I never saw him worried even once. Instead, I always saw him taking care of his hardships, and I am determined to honor what he taught me. During the last night of the Festival of Summer Wonders in Meadowgrass Village, when the townsfolk were walking towards the Lake of Dreams, a group of approaching lights caught the attention of the residents. When the lights were getting closer, the carriage and flags were unmistakable. The King and Queen of Norlo and her beautiful daughter Amelia had arrived in Meadowgrass Village.
Thank you. Thank you.